Hey guys, what is up? It's Abby again with a new Sakura Card Captors Clear Card anime review. First of all, I want to apologize because I've been extremely tired and I probably need some medicine. How do you call it? Vitamins, maybe? But yeah, my health hasn't been well. I've been exhausted, tired, and I can barely do things because I need to sleep a lot for some reason. Anyway, this episode, Sakura and the Upside Down Penguin. Again. Because we had that on the first series. Anyways, into the review. This episode starts with Sakura, Tomoyo, and Shonan discussing about the new card that she has gotten on the episode before. Actually, it was two cards. It was the Labyrinth and the Snooze. Tomoyo points out that looks familiar. It looks like the Maze, which I mentioned on the episode before, and the Snooze, that looks like Sleep, which did the same effect with her dad on the first series. Sakura dozes off on her math class because, hey, maybe what Tomoyo said was true. So that means aqua is watery. That means siege is windy. That means, hey Sakura, are you listening? The teacher asks and she's like, yes. I'm listening. Yeah, but you shouldn't doze off during class. Okay, sensei, thank you. Well now, we cut to a lunch break. With Sakura, Tomoyo, Akiho, Naoko, and Chiharu chatting about stuff, especially the new script that Naoko wrote. I mean, she was fun with literature, sorry about that, and you know, I like to write scripts and see them to become theoretical piece instead of a novel. Akiho is impressed by Naoko's abilities because she wrote the story of the last card. The movie, you know, the movie when Sakura confesses Shouran that she likes him as well. Yeah, she wrote that. I didn't remember that. I've only seen once, I mean. Shouran and Yamazaki show up because, yeah, they were a little bit late. They were talking to the teacher about the sports events that the school will be having. Yeah, there isn't much, I mean, on the school this year, but Sakura asks Akiho what's her favorite sport, and she says tennis, which, funny enough, is my favorite as well, but that's hard. But Akiho has been practicing since she was little, so she would be okay. However, they don't have tennis this year, so the sports they have is volleyball, tennis table, badminton, volleyball, and basketball. Badminton is actually close enough, which I used to play a lot with my brother and at school. And Akiho, yeah, it is. And surprisingly enough, Yamazaki tells a story that is true. Yeah. He was telling the truth this time. That's quite new from him. Not lying about badminton. That's something I always said, badminton and not bat-minton. Who the fudge says bat? It's not like have a little bat. I mean, I get it. Bat from the other bat, not bat the animal. Sorry, just had to make a pun. After school, none of them will go to the club's activities because teachers have something to do or they're taking the day off. Yeah, so as Akiho Sakura and Shara are walking back. They come across with Kaito. You know, Yuna, the Kaito, you know, the caretaker of Akiho. He went to the store to get some stuff, but yeah, they come across. Akiho wants to help out, but he says no, there's no need, and yeah, he walks Akiho back. However, when they were introducing themselves, Shara felt a strange presence. He doesn't like Kaito at all. So there's something that Shara is doing. Finally, he's feeling energies from Kaito, and Sakura is not. So that's something in advantage for Shara. As he returns home, Sharan calls Ariel, which they discussed about it. However, there's something that got Ariel's attention. He has D, not D. He's named D, you know. And Ariel explains that the D are high-ranked magic users from England. He didn't know about it. Maybe his mom didn't tell him yet, because probably they are related to the moon, which can become troublesome for Shara. And yeah, I mean, he had trouble fighting Yue, if you saw the first series. So that's something important to take in mind. While they were chit-chatting, Mizuki, I still say it's Mitsuki because full moon, whatever. Mizuki is at the door, and Ariel does and opens the door for Mizuki, and they have a little break. Of course, England, it's 4 o'clock. I get it. Get it? Tea time. In England, it's 4 o'clock. I know. Anyways, this is for the first part, but almost at the end, Mizuki and Ariel have a little cute moment. Hey, Mizuki, aren't you a grown-up? Isn't Ariel a kid? On the second part of the episode, Sakura and Toya are having some dinner time, and they're chit-chatting, and Sakura, your brother is amazing. Just saying. My brother is cool too, but you know, he's annoying sometimes. I understand your pain, Sakura, even though I'm the eldest. And Toya has to leave because he has a work to go to. Yeah, that guy works a lot. Really, he does. And Sakura calls Kaito because he left. Yay! They are free to move around as they please. And Sakura tells Kaito that he can eat those muffins while she washes the dishes. And when she finishes it, Sakura and Kaito then rush into where she feels the presence of the card. And guess what? The penguin, the king penguin, is upside down. Again. Because that happened before with the power card. Yeah. Yes, it was power card. Strength and power are very similar. But nonetheless, this time, Kaito is the one that is filming Sakura because Tomoyo can't do everything all the time, sometimes. So she got Kaito a camera so she can get filmed. Sakura, you won't escape. That's your destiny, to be filmed by Tomoyo. Regardless, Sakura is having trouble capturing the card, even though she feels the presence of it Yeah, the card is playing around, putting everything upside down, and that was not a pun or anything, but yeah. She can't even capture the card because Sakura is also put upside down. Kero helps her, but they need to think fast about a new plan. Kero has an idea. Hey, maybe they can't get a hold of you if you're hanging around. And what that means is use flight. And that works. And Sakura captures reversal. Reversal. Yeah, that was about to get busted because as soon as they finish capturing the card, people start to show up. What happened? The penguin is upside down. Everything is upside down. What happened? Even the news crew showed up. They were lucky they weren't caught, but still, it was a close call. But yeah, I mean, this is a really, really short review of the episode 11, Sakura and the Reversal Penguin. And déjà vu again. Everything is getting déjà vu over and over, and it goes by what I said in some comments because the cards are very similar. I'm having a blank. I'm exhausted. I'm sorry. Even talking makes me exhausted. I have no idea. I need to take some supplements to get my energy back. So, yeah, guys, thanks a lot for watching. I'll be seeing you on my next video, depending on what it is, a drawing video, a comic dub, a haul, a review, speed paint, whatever that will be, I'll be seeing you then. And if you're new to the channel, please make sure you like, comment, share with people that might enjoy, subscribe if you haven't already, and like always, guys, thanks a lot for watching. I'll be seeing you next time, and like always, take care.